ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930 present The Drive.
It is Friday, April 12th. Your drive begins now on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. I'm your host, Paul Swann. Our text line this hour will be 304-396-TALK. That's 304-396-8255. Big news today coming out of Marshall. Thundering herd. They've got their coach. Marshall announcing earlier today that Juli Fulks will be the ninth head coach for the Marshall University women's basketball team. She is previously from Transylvania University. She is an impressive coach. You look at her achievements. She has done amazing things, especially with that program, in just 10 seasons with the program. Now, she has a record of over 400 wins. But with Transylvania, 242 wins. Six Heartland Collegiate Athletic Conference titles, seven NCAA tournament appearances, three Elite Eights, two Final Fours, and a national championship with Transy. So she's the next head coach of the Marshall women's basketball team, and it is official, not just official. Board of Governors met not that long ago, and they approved the deal. Brad Smith, after the board made it unanimous, had this to say.
We are blessed to have Coach Juli Fulks joining us. We have caught lightning in the bottle yet again, and we're excited for the season coming up.
So there'll be an official introductory press conference on Tuesday. We will be there for that. So what do we know about this coach other than a resume? We're going to find out more. Coming up in the next few minutes, we are going to talk to Lyndsey Gough from WKYT in Lexington. She's covered Transylvania for years. She has a lot of insight about the new coach. So we'll find out more about what this coach is all about. What kind of style of play can we expect? So we'll talk to Lyndsey in just a few minutes about that. As I mentioned, we'll get your text in this hour as well, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Also, we're going to hear a little bit later on from John Mercer, Marshall's tennis coach, the Herd in action, taking on App State. We haven't talked to John in a few weeks, so I thought today would be a good time to get him back in on the show. So he's checking in a little bit after 5:30 or so. Just depends on how long we go with Lyndsey. So that's coming up. We'll talk about the new hire with Marshall, introducing folks on Tuesday. It's a good get. What do you think? There were a few names thrown out there. I don't think anyone really threw folks' name out there. I didn't see it come up anywhere. But you look at a resume, it's a good hire. It's a great risk-reward hire. There's risk. You're hiring a Division III coach, but what a track record. And I think if she's successful, the rewards are going to be very similar to what you saw with Marshall hiring then Kim Stevens, Kim Caldwell taking the Thundering Herd to its first ever Sun Belt regular season title, and then following that up with its first ever Sun Belt tournament title and only its second NCAA appearance in program history. And of course, Tennessee's thought that that was a very attractive package. And so she is moving up to Tennessee. So it's time to maybe think out of the box. And I thought maybe Marshall would look Division II, but Division III and Transy is definitely a program that has basketball success. And also, come on, she's in Kentucky. It's a basketball state. Lexington, it's a basketball crazy area. She's got this covered. She can handle this. I don't think there's going to be much of a transition from Division III to D1 at Marshall. It seemed to work out just fine for Caldwell. I think it'll work out just fine for Fulks. So she's coming on the program hopefully Tuesday. At least we'll be at the press conference, and we're going to try to get her on the program here in the near future. But I'm hoping we can do that on Tuesday. If we don't get her one-on-one, we'll definitely be a part of the presser with her. And I'm hoping that she can join me. We're going to be over at the ballpark on Tuesday, by the way. Marshall's taking on Moorhead. We're going to carry that game. We got a makeup game to do. So we don't know when Marshall's going to be able to play Virginia Tech. We got a makeup game. We got to get in. So we're doing the Moorhead game. Jason Toy will be there with Bill Cornwell and Woody Woodrum, and the rest of us will all be there. Should be a fun one. So we'll be at the ballpark on Tuesday. I'm hoping that Coach Fulks can come over and join me. No promises, but Tuesday we get the presser, we got baseball, we got a lot happening. But when we continue, we're going to talk to Lyndsey Gough. She is from WKYT in Lexington. She has covered Transylvania, including runs and the NCAA tournament. Again, you're getting a coach that has taken a program to seven NCAA tournaments. That includes three Elite Eights. That includes two Final Fours. And that includes one NCAA title. Impressive. You get a coach that at one point, get this, at one point, they were 91-2 overall. A 64-game winning streak at one point at Transylvania, and that's coming to Marshall. So you should be excited about the hire. I want to hear from you, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. But when we continue, let's find out more about the new coach. Lyndsey Gough joins us from WKYT when we continue on this edition of The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
Welcome back to the Friday, April 12th edition of The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. I'm your host, Paul Swann. Our text line this hour, 304-396-TALK. That's 304-396-8255. Still to come on the program, we're going to hear from John Mercer. Thundering Herd's taking on Appalachian State this weekend. We got to talk about that. The Herd and the Mountaineers coming up this weekend. Mercer joins us on the program in just a few minutes. Let's get you updated on softball. Thundering Herd taking on JMU on the road. And after three, the Herd leads it 4-1. So off to a good start taking on JMU on the softball field. Joining us now on the program, she covers University of Kentucky and, of course, Transylvania basketball for WKYT in Lexington. Lyndsey Gough is with us, and earlier today we found out that Juli Fulks was named as the ninth head coach for Marshall University, replacing Kim Caldwell, which accepted a job at Tennessee. Thanks for joining me, Lyndsey, and Herd fans are curious. You're losing a basketball coach that was even rumored for the Kentucky vacancy, and she goes to Tennessee, and so now Marshall goes down to the Division III ranks to pick up a national championship coach. What should we know about Juli Fulks?
Well, I'll say behind the scenes, some folks had even floated Juli Fulks out for that Kentucky position. She's a heck of a basketball coach and a great person. I've enjoyed covering her program tremendously. Can't say enough good things about her. Her teams are well coached. They rarely make mistakes. Very, very heavy on the fundamentals. They shoot the three. They play great defense. I think Marshall made a home run hire with this one.
What kind of style of play can we expect? With Caldwell, it was just really active, five players in, five players out. It almost was like a hockey shift the way that she rotated her players. Mm-hmm. A lot of high energy. People were excited for that. And can we expect something similar with Juli, or will she have a different style altogether?
I think it'll be a different style. And I say this with the caveat, when she's at Transies, the competition level is very different, obviously. They blew teams out of the water for 2 years. Their starters hardly ever played in the fourth quarter. I doubt that happens moving up to the Division I level in the Sun Belt. So I don't think you'll expect as much of that. They're probably going to need their starters to carry a little more load than she did at Transy, but they do like to shoot the three ball. They attack the glass. They get a lot of rebounds. And like I said, they rarely make mistakes. I mean, it was something if you saw Transy turn the ball over a couple of times in a half. Like, they don't turn the ball over. They don't take bad shots. They are just so sound. It's incredible to watch. It's like methodical. They just pick these teams apart. And they rely. One thing about Transy, you have to be pretty smart to get into Transy. And they relied very heavily on analytics for other teams. They like to look at the numbers and crunch the numbers, and that was how they attacked teams and picked them apart. I imagine she'll probably try to implement that there as well. It really worked for them. And it's something to watch, I'll tell you.
As far as recruiting is concerned, what's the type of player she usually looks for? You mentioned it's very tough to get into Transylvania. You mm-hmm. got to be pretty smart to get in, so I'm sure she's looking for really sharp, smart kids. But what style of player is she looking for? A little quicker, a little bit more athletic, a nice mix?
Yeah, a lot of the players at Transy were honestly undersized. That was what happened to them in the Final Four this past year. They played, there was two undefeated teams playing, and NYU was just bigger than Transy. And that ended up being a problem. They were, so I think, you know, at the Division I level, she'll be able to get more size in there. But, yeah, really, really smart players that, I know I keep saying it, they just don't make a lot of mistakes. Now, most of her Transy players, right, are going on to be, like, engineers, doctors. They're, like, dual majors and doing all these other things. Most of them don't have aspirations at maybe playing at the professional level like you would see in a Division I player. But, yes, yeah, she likes quick players. Most of them are pretty gritty, even though they're smart. You know, they were all undersized, under-recruited, and ready to kind of come out and prove themselves. And she was able to motivate them to do that. You know, they called themselves at Transy the last couple of years the gold standard. And they held themselves to that. They believed that, you know, and it showed. I mean, they went undefeated for 63 games, I think it was.
Impressive mark there. I was going to ask you, she seems to have a really good setup at Transylvania. Were you surprised when you heard the news that she had taken the Marshall job? Was it maybe time for her to step up to another level, or, you know, was this completely a surprise to everyone?
Yes and no. I think she was definitely comfortable at Transylvania, and she did have a good setup and had been at the Division III level for a long time. I think she played Division III ball herself, so that was something, you know, she was familiar with. But that first class through Transy, the fifth-year seniors, she graduated a very large class and was going to have a rebuilding job to do. So I think if you were going to take the jump and go up to Division I and, you know, try to see if you can recreate that success at the Division I level, now would be the time to do it, right? She has a young assistant on staff that I think is probably poised to take her place at Transy if that ends up how it works out. And I don't have any inside knowledge saying that. That's just a gut feeling there. But she did lose a large chunk of her roster. So I would say if you wanted to take that challenge, take that step up, now would be the perfect time to do that.
Our guest is Lyndsey Gough. She works at WKYT. She's doing double duty today, trying to cover what's happening at the University of Kentucky and, of course, with Transylvania. Yeah, you're really all over the place as far as what's happening. I mean, something changes every single day. And, of course, you know, Huntington borders Ashland, Kentucky, so there's a lot of interest in everything that's happening with UK as well. So, you know, what can you share with us at this moment? What seems to be the pulse of what's happening?
Yeah, well, Mark Pope is the guy. Kentucky has made that official, so he will be the next Kentucky men's basketball coach, a 1996 champion at UK under Rick Pitino. I think the fan base is kind of split on him right now. He doesn't have any NCAA tournament wins, which proven success is something that's very important to this fan base. But I just heard an interview with Rick Pitino, and he said, you know, when I came in, I was kind of unproven, and I was rebuilding this program from the ground up, right? Kentucky had been out of the tournament and they were in trouble, like completely rebuilding. And he was like, Mark Pope doesn't have that situation. You know, Kentucky's not buried right now. Like, they're not at their best, but it's still Kentucky. And, you know, they've made the tournament. They've won a championship in 2012. It wasn't that long ago. So Mark Pope isn't starting from square one, which is good. And if you could take BYU to the tournament, I think you can get Kentucky to the tournament. And he was roommates with Jeff Shepherd in 1996. And Jeff has just said that he had a conversation with Mark Pope about Reed Shepherd, and they're still gathering information, but he didn't rule out Reed Shepherd returning for a second year, which would be insane. So there's mixed bag, I think, how the fans feel about Mark Pope, but he is the guy, and that's become official today. So, I personally, as an alum, I went to Kentucky and I also cover Kentucky. I like the hire. You know, their top three weren't interested, and this guy gets it. He understands the pressure that's on this job, the pressure cooker that the fans kind of put you in. And he was part of that 96 team that, again, people expected it was championship or bust. So he understands what that's like, and he seems like a really positive, upbeat guy, which I think the program could use right now.
Outside looking in, my chips were on Billy Donovan. That's where my chips were.
Yeah. My thing with Billy Donovan is he has been out of the college game for so long, and he got out because he didn't enjoy the recruiting aspect, and that's only gotten crazier with NIL and the transfer portal. And so I don't know that he wanted to undertake that. I think he's a great coach, obviously. Ties to Kentucky, he's been on their bench before, but I think he's content in the NBA at this point.
Lyndsey Gough with us, WKYT in Lexington. Where can fans follow you if they want to keep up on the latest with UK?
Yeah, my Twitter is at LG on TV. Nice and easy for everybody to remember. You can search up my Facebook page as well. I'm usually more active on Twitter, however. And then we've got the latest all weekend over at WKYT.com.
Lyndsey, thanks for doing it today. Really excited. I think everybody hopefully has got their coach today.
Yeah, you guys have got a great one in Juli Fulks. I could say that. Her teams were a pleasure to follow. I went to the national championship with them last year, and I went to the Final Four with them this year, and she was great about allowing access and always very transparent with us, and her players were a joy. The teams were fun to cover, so I think Marshall fans are in for a treat.
Lyndsey Gough, everyone, WKYT in Lexington. Lyndsey, thanks for doing it.
Of course. Thanks for having me.
That was fun. That was fun. Good get, I think, for the Thundering Herd. So already my impressions are even higher of Juli Fulks. We'll find out more about her on Tuesday. There will be an introductory press conference for her. And, of course, after that, we'll start getting to know the head coach a little bit better. You heard the president earlier say, lightning in a bottle twice. Those are big, big expectations for the next coach, the new coach of the Marshall women's basketball team. So we'll find out more again on Tuesday. We will be there, and I'm looking forward to it. All right, when we continue, we'll update you on what's happening with Marshall softball, and then we're going to hear from the head coach of the Marshall tennis team, John Mercer, joins us. It's been a while. We've talked to him in a good bit. So Appalachian State's the opponent. Marshall Tennis, we'll talk to him. And we'll get your text in. Don't forget that. The text line is open. Let's get your impressions. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. More coming up on today's edition of The Drive, ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
Our text line is open, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Football news today, Thundering Herd announcing it will play Wisconsin September 2nd, 2028. It's a one-game deal, and it'll be the season opener for both Wisconsin and for the Thundering Herd. So Marshall's starting to rack up a lot of Big Ten foes on the schedule. You know, under Coach Huff, this team's really good about knocking off big-time teams in the first few weeks of the season. I don't know if Wisconsin got the memo, but 2028, the Thundering Herd making the trip to Madison to take on the Wisconsin Badgers. My next guest, he's no stranger to taking on big-time programs. He's the head coach of the Marshall tennis team, John Mercer, getting set for App State tomorrow. You've played Wisconsin in tennis before, right? You played the Badgers.
Yes, we did.
Yeah.
Yeah, we did. I think we have a winning record, right? 1-0.
Yeah. You beat the Big Ten time and time again. That's what you do.
Occasionally. Occasionally we get one. So that was a good one. They were nice enough to come play us at home.
So nice.
That was really great of them. Yep.
Yeah, very nice. John Mercer's with us tomorrow, getting set for App State. Your squad is 16-7, 7-2 in Sun Belt. And again, we're still getting used to the fact that actually you have conference matches. Taking on the Mountaineers, they're 12-7, 6-3 in league play. So competitive Sun Belt season so far. What have you seen from the league, and what do you see from App State?
From the league, pretty good. I mean, you have Old Dominion at the top, who's the legitimate, really top 25 team on paper. So they're pretty tough, but they're beatable, as is everybody. And then, you kind of have, I guess we're in second right now by percentage points or so, but you got three or four teams that are all pretty close in there. So and then after that, it's another strong group right after that. But a lot of parity, which is really interesting as the season goes along to kind of see how you know, teams are kind of playing out after the non-conference portion of the season. And App State, you know, they're a good team. Very good at the top. We should have some really tough matches at the top. Hopefully our depth plays well for us. That's what we're kind of counting on tomorrow. And, you know, we should be a good, good match to watch, and should be pretty close. We lost them last year down there. It was a little bit of an upset. So, you know, hopefully we can return the favor when they come visit us.
Now, tennis is structured a little different than some of the other sports, but now that you have an actual conference schedule, we're going through it again the second time. Have you noticed that there's maybe an uptick as far as excitement when it comes to these conference matchups, or, you know, are you developing nice rivalries? Is that still too early, or, you know, have you zeroed in on a couple schools? Is App State one of them as far as teams that, all right, you want to beat them all, but especially this one?
Yeah, it doesn't take long to form rivalries, that's for sure. And then, you know, it's kind of fun. You know, we've been here a while coaching this team. So, you know, of course, we kind of got back to playing some of the old Southern Conference schools that we started with when my wife and I started coaching here. So that was kind of fun. App State being one of them. So Georgia Southern another. So, you know, it's kind of neat to be back in that world and back in the South again and playing these schools. ODU, you know, of course, we had to bring them with us from Conference USA. They were already a pretty good rival in Conference USA. We've had our battles with them over the years, won our fair share, lost some close ones. But, yeah, so you started out with that right away. James Madison, they're another one that we used to play a lot, even though they weren't in our conference. You know, just because they were in our region, Tennessee has 16 regions. So, you know, we had TMU was already in our region, and, you know, we always had some good matchups against them also. So, like I said, it doesn't take long to form some rivalries, and, you know, that's what makes it fun. It's fun to play a regular season and get to go to the other schools and play on their campuses and, you know, see what they're all about. And, you know, it makes for a great, you know, second half of the year. You know, you're really playing for some true conference seedings, and, you know, that's what we're going to get, you know, see where we're seated in the tournament and then see if we can make a run. So it makes a lot more fun, I think, you know, playing that regular season schedule.
John Mercer's with us, Marshall's tennis coach, the Thundering Herd taking on the App State Mountaineers. That's coming up tomorrow, 10 a.m. at the Brian David Fox Tennis Center. So a early start for your squad taking on the Mountaineers. Hopefully the weather is going to cooperate. I know some of your marketing people don't like it when I mention weather, John, but hopefully everything's going to be fine for tennis tomorrow. You know, where are you most happy with? Who are you most happy with, or where are you at? What's made you the most satisfied, or, you know, you're pleased with as far as what you're getting performance-wise from your top part of the rotation?
I think you know, what we've done well this year was that we've been pretty consistent with everybody showing up and competing pretty hard. Sometimes for us, we're pretty balanced. So what's kind of separated us from, you know, a lot of the teams is that if a team's really good at the top, you know, and not so good lower down the lineup, you know, we've been able to win lower down the lineup, and then vice versa. If they're good lower in the lineup, you know, we've seen them be able to come out on top. So, you know, we've had a lot of consistency, you know, from everybody, a lot of depth. And that's kind of what's separating us. So, you know, we're still pretty strong as you get down lower into those, you know, 4, 5, 6 spots. And that's really played well for us. But, you know, Johanna, JoJo, as we call her, you know, who's played one this year for us. She was freshman of the year last year in the Sun Belt. You know, she's had a real good season, and she'll have a good one tomorrow. You know, the girl that plays one for App State's pretty good. But, you know, it makes a big difference, you know, playing at these different facilities. You know, we go last weekend, we went down to South Alabama, and, you know, the courts were really slow, and it was a lot warmer than it had been, you know, where we've been practicing. And, you know, teams come up here now they're playing in some cooler weather tomorrow morning, you know, low 50s, a little bit of a breeze, you know, it plays. You definitely get these home court advantages. So, you know, that's what's been pretty cool to see. But you know, as far as the lineup goes, you know, we just ask everybody to show up and compete hard and you know, see if we can get 4 points every day.
And that's deliberate. You're playing in cold weather. You know what you're doing, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, they're used to it. I mean, really, every match we've played this year outside of this past weekend at Southern Miss and South Alabama, it's pretty much been 50 degrees and a little breezy. So, you know, that's kind of the tough part. The conference sets these 10 a.m. starts, which we need to work on. But, you know, you get further north, like where we are, you know, if you play at 10, it's 53 degrees. If you play at 1, it's 63 degrees. So, you know, it is what it is. And, you know, we try to embrace it and, you know, realize that this is what we practice in and play in all the time. So, you know, we feel it's our advantage.
What's the purpose? What's the perfect time then? If 10 a.m. is not it, what's the perfect time?
I like, you know, on Fridays, I like that 4 p.m. start.
Yeah.
You know, we seem to get really good crowd attendance at 4. You know, people sneak out of work a little bit earlier, and, you know, that's a good time. Saturday's 1. You know, midday is pretty good. But, you know, a lot of that's set up due to travel, you know, trying to get teams in and out. You're playing, you know, Friday, Saturday, Saturday, Sundays. They're trying to get to the next site, so. I understand it, you know, from that standpoint, but again, it's not really helping our sport when it comes to fan attendance. We're not really being fan friendly. So I don't know. We'll have to have some discussions as far as that goes, in my opinion.
And that's something you can talk to the conference about. That's more of a conference issue than anything.
Yeah. Yeah. And they're really open to things. I mean, they're fantastic. You know, they listen, they weigh things. We made a lot of changes last year going into the conference tournament this year, 'cause they'd gone from a, you know, 10-team tournament to all of a sudden a 14-team tournament. And there's a lot of logistics. And so, you know, there's a lot of changes that need done. And they're very open and very understanding and want to do the best for everybody. So I'm sure they'll listen to, you know, the suggestions that we have this year as far as coaches go.
John Mercer's with us again. It's coming up tomorrow. It's the Brian David Fox Tennis Center, 10 a.m. You're going to have donuts again for all the students, try to coax them out of their beds.
I'm sure we will.
Have you tried?
Never go wrong with donuts, right?
Yeah. Have you tried pizza? Other things like that?
Not at the 10 a.m. start. So, yeah.
John,
10 a.m. starts. We stay at the donut.
These are college kids. Are you seriously? Come on.
Are we talking cold pizza here or warm pizza?
I mean, does it matter? It's pizza. You've seen basketball games where these people are jumping up and down for pizza.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
Go with the pizza. You could do donuts, pizza. I don't know. You could do, what are the kids liking more, Starbucks or Dunkin'? What are you seeing more from the kids?
Right now, I'm seeing a little bit more of the Starbucks.
Okay. So you could have Starbucks out there.
Yeah. We'll have to call Sydney, you know, and have her work on it, get our marketing department on this, right?
Right.
So,
like, just have
I'll have you talk to them. How about that?
Yeah. I mean, sure. I'll make that happen. Obviously.
Place your order with Sydney and you're good.
Okay. Sydney will have to, Sydney Shelton, marketing director over and fan engagement. We'll have to get the Starbucks, just get the Starbucks set up.
Love me now.
Yeah. Because after all, Starbucks and donuts, those were college kids love. They live for that.
There you go. That's right.
I like
it. A few adults are still like that. Yep.
No, it's the adults. It really is. John Mercer's with us. He's the head coach of the Marshall tennis team and taking on App State and trying to stay on top of the Sun Belt standings, 7-2, you know, looking for that 1 or 2 seed. And if that's the case, pretty good shot here. Once again, let's get this program back into the NCAA tournament. You got a trophy stand to try to fill. You got that trophy, you know. You got to put that there.
That would be nice.
Right?
That's the goal.
Yeah.
So that's definitely the goal. Yeah.
And you know, if soccer wins the spring league, there's a trophy. So I'm wondering if that would count. Is that just Sun Belt trophies? Explain that to those who don't know. Is it just Sun Belt trophies?
Right. Yeah. So when you walk in the Shuey building, there's a display there. And whoever is the latest team to win the conference title – win a conference championship, they get to display their trophy there. So it would be wonderful to have a tennis trophy there. I'd love that.
Okay, so we're going to have to put a tennis trophy there real soon. John Mercer's with us, and don't forget, It's tomorrow. It's at the Brian David Fox Tennis Center, 10 a.m. start. Hopefully you'll get a good crowd. A lot of people maybe will want to start their Saturday morning supporting the Thundering Herd. Good luck. We'll talk to you soon. And I know you're in Lexington right now, right, to cheer on your son.
That would be true. They're taking on Georgia today, so a big match. So they win today, they clinch at least a tie for the conference championship. So they'll get their own trophy.
You know, when you told me you were heading to Lexington earlier, the first thing I thought was that that Christian Spears has sent you down personally to pick up the new head coach of the Marshall women's basketball team, Juli Fulks, or at least deliver a fruit basket. I don't know which, but that's the first thought in my mind when you said, hey, I'm in Lexington right now.
That sounds definitely like Christian. If you knew I was coming, I probably would have been on top of that. So, yes, we need to welcome her, and I'm sure she'll do a fantastic job. You can't have all the success she did without being a great coach. So I'm sure she'll do great.
Yeah, looking forward to it. So I guess I'll see you maybe Tuesday at the Henderson Center, if not sooner.
That sounds great. We'll see you there. Thanks. Hopefully this weekend.
Yes, sir.
See you tomorrow, Paul.
It's going to be cold, man. You better have the hot chocolate. Hot chocolate. Not Starbucks. It's too hot chocolate.
Come on now.
Hot chocolate and
cold. You're tough, Paul. You're tough.
Cold pizza. Hot chocolate, cold pizza. Let's do it.
Come tailgate. So then it's a football game.
John Mercer, my guest. Thanks, buddy. Good talking to you.
Thank you. Go hard.
All right, John Mercer. He'll be personally giving out hot chocolate, cold pizza, donuts, whatever else you want from him. More coming up on this edition of The Drive, ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
Welcome back to the Friday edition of The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. I'm your host, Paul Swann, taking your text this hour, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. We've had a busy day so far. Two big stories coming out for the Thundering Herd. First up, you just joined us, Juli Fulks, named the ninth head coach of Marshall women's basketball history. She takes over a job that Kim Caldwell had for a year, which saw the Thundering Herd reach the Sun Belt Championship game of the tournament and win that after winning the regular season title. And then, of course, an appearance in the NCAA tournament that hadn't happened in years. So I had gone back to Marshall to just wrap up some credit hours. I had left Marshall, got the job in radio here in Huntington, and then I was going back for a season or so to wrap up some credit hours and got to see the Thundering Herd that year go to the NCAA tournament, which I thought was super cool. And, of course, now Marshall has gone back, got a little taste for it, and hopefully the Thundering Herd will be able to continue the success laid down by Kim Caldwell. And it seems like Juli Fulks is definitely going to be an interesting coach. A lot of Moneyball philosophy. That's what has come up. Likes the metrics, likes the analytics, smart teams. They're very well-disciplined. Lot of undersized opportunities there. I guess what I'm trying to say is she's not going to have to worry about undersized players anymore. I think she's going to be able to recruit a different caliber of athlete here. And she was successful at Transylvania, Transy as they like to call it, able to win a national championship there. So I can't wait to see what she can do when she has a little bit more resources. I'm sure she's used to doing less with – you go from Division III to Division I. I think the big thing here is it's resources. She was successful with what she had at Transylvania. – Now she's going to have opportunity to continue, and we've seen it already can happen. Now Kim Caldwell had a different style of basketball, and I'm sure that you're going to bring in maybe a more traditional style of basketball, but they have been very dominant in Division III at Transylvania for some time now, so it's good to see that possibly being brought over to Marshall and continued the success we've had in the Sun Belt. And of course, the other one was, of course, Marshall's set to take on Wisconsin. It's going to be a one-game deal. for the 2028 season. September 2nd, it's going to be the home opener for Wisconsin. It's going to be the season opener for the Thundering Herd. Second time these two teams have met. Actually, going to be 20-year anniversary since these two teams met. Marshall, at one point, had a 14-point lead over Wisconsin. It was September 6, 2008. You got to go back a ways. And Marshall actually had Wisconsin for a while, and unfortunately, Wisconsin, nationally ranked, got the better of the Herd. So Marshall now, it's pretty much set, just about. Marshall has three of its four non-conference opponents set for the 2028 season. Marshall has Ohio. It's the battle for the bell that season. Still to be a game scheduled, but Marshall's got Central Connecticut on the books. We don't know when that's going to happen just yet. We got to get the rest of this non-conference schedule first, but Wisconsin, Ohio, Central Connecticut. That's the schedule so far. And that's 2028. We got a ways to go. We got a ways to go. It is only 2024. We got a few years to go on that one. So are you excited to take the trip to see Thundering Herd take on Wisconsin? Taking a trip to Madison? Marshall's been leaning a little heavy in those Big Ten stadiums as of late. I think that's actually a good approach. If you're looking for a big game on your schedule, I think you should take some of those Big Ten games. They're easier to get to. Now, I like the warm weather games too, don't get me wrong. But if you're going to schedule opponents, I think you look at some of those Big Ten opponents a little bit more. You got Ohio State coming up. I think that's important. You got to take advantage of some of those teams, the proximity. A little easier for fans to get to. I mean, still, you take one of those games now and then. Maybe you go somewhere else. Maybe you go somewhere warm. But you got to take advantage of some of those opportunities if they're out there. You shouldn't have to drive past too many places to get a good non-conference game. If you're driving, if you're going past, say, Ohio State to get to somewhere else, maybe look into getting Ohio State. Get them on a schedule, and I'm sure that they'll obviously have an opening here or there, put you in the rotation. It makes sense for them. They know that the non-conference side of things, as far as ticket sales, you don't really have to worry about that too much, but you know the visitors will always, probably more than likely, buy all those up. So there'll be interest in the game. Makes sense. And, of course, Wisconsin, it's not that bad of a trip, is it? We got a few years to plan, so don't worry about that. We got a few years to plan. So coming up on Monday, we'll know more about Marshall's new basketball coach on the women's side, Juli Fulks. That was announced today. We'll know more about her. There's the press conference on Tuesday, the introductory press conference for her. We hope to hear from her. Also, the athletic director, Christian Spears, Brad Smith as well. That will be at the introductory press conference on Tuesday. And we also have baseball coming up that Tuesday as well, as the Herd taking on Morehead State. That's going to be at Jack Cook Field. We're going to be at that contest. That is coming up. I will be there at the stadium. We'll have the game right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930 as the Thundering Herd getting set to take on Louisiana this weekend after beating West Virginia. What a fun game. If you weren't there on Wednesday, it was a fun game. The weather was not that bad. And I tell you what, Marshall's got a nice little winning streak going on. They're definitely winning series at home. It's been pretty fun so far, first season of baseball at Jack Cook Field. But, of course, we'll be back in action on Tuesday on the radio side. Marshall, Morehead State, right here, ESPN 94.1 at AM 930. I want to thank my guests. First up, John Mercer, Marshall women's tennis coach. Don't forget, Herd's taking on App State tomorrow at 10 a.m. And I want to thank Lyndsey Gough from WKYT in Lexington, giving us a little bit more insight on what we can expect with Marshall's new women's coach, Juli Fulks. Coming in from Transylvania. That's what they call it, Transy. That's going to do it. Thanks for tuning in. Be back with you on Monday here, ESPN 94.1 at AM 930.
Transmitting on Glorious FM on 94.1 W227BS Huntington. This is 930 WRVC Huntington, celebrating 100 years of broadcasting.